Team New Zealand capsize.
The video published by Emirates Team New Zealand and another amatorial video.
Esatto, taken from another boat, from another with boat. People laughing.
they had quite a
good time. Seeing this kind of maneuver. We saw this capsize. The first one we can see and
see. Exactly. We don't know if the teams are capsizing every day. Probably
yes. Looks like they had a quite efficient maneuver of putting the boat upright again.
Exactly.
So maybe, but we don't know. Maybe it was the 20th time they tried to put the boat again on its feet. So we don't know. It's really on his feet. Okay. Anyway, what was the dynamic behind the maneuver?
So, exactly. So the boat was jibing.
Was a foiling jibe and the quite
fast.
Fast. Exactly.
So as we are saying, we are seeing in the videos the boats are trying now to push and try to reach the limits of the boat, in this case overtake the limit of the boat.
Exactly. So they're pushing the boundaries of what can be done on with this kind of boats. So exactly. Obviously the same maneuver made more gently could have ended in a much different way.
Exactly.
In this case
the wind was not so high, quite light wind, so probably they took the risk to do this kind of maneuver. And so they jibed quite fast, so it was not a really round jibe as we saw in the videos published recently by all the teams.
I mean, you see in the first part of the video, the very first part of the video, you see the arm, the new leeward arm that is going down in the water, so you see easily the splash of the arm of the foil in the water. So, and you see the maneuver is starting suddenly.
Exactly.
Exactly.
So, the maneuver is starting immediately. It's really fast. For sure they are trying to whether push the limits or trying a new way
of maneuvering.
The new foil actually is going up in the same way as it always does, so probably we think it's an automatic routine.
Exactly, for sure routine.
But actually the boat, just after the jibe, the boat goes bow down and hits the water.
It's not a real nosedive, but for sure it touched the water quite
a bit.
Quite a bit, exactly. So what we can imagine is that someone at some point decided to put it again horizontal, no?
Exactly, so probably the flight controller probably was giving a high lift on the...
High positive lift.
Lift on the arms, on the foils, and probably...
Especially on the new leeward, the new leeward one, while the other one was suddenly going up.
Exactly.
For the sailing position normal.
So probably he was going full lift, so full trim, with the leeward foil, and in the same time also probably the trimmers of the sails were trying to have the as much power as possible. Because the wind foil was already out, so they could have all the power they want. The problem is they probably whether exceeded in the correction. Or maybe also we can think
something happened. The flight controller
losing control, the wrong button
or whatever.
Exactly.
So in the end, they found themselves with full lift on the foil for sure.
and then power on the sales.
Full power on the sales with the ARM up, which by the way, along the movement when it's going up very very fast, what happens is that in the first time it is healing the boat to windward just because of the movement, and also puts the bow down again, no, with
exactly.
With this kind of movement when it's going out of the water. But when it comes out of the water, then this kind of force
exactly.
suddenly stops,
exactly.
and then
exactly.
you feel it obviously in the setup of
exactly.
the boat.
So when the windward foil stops, the windward arm stops, actually the boat has the inertia to go actually up, nose up, and to leeward, so to heel
exactly.
to leeward. So probably this all these kind of things again together with the too much correction take the boat in the mode of nose up completely
yes,
yeah. opposite
in
mode,
the mode
so.
Of real take off, so
exactly.
it was trying to go in the air, but at some point it
exactly.
reached the
exactly.
reached the point where the foil was completely out of the water, or
exactly.
we don't know if it had the time of ventilating, probably
exactly.
not, probably not, because it was just going straight outside
the
water, as a dolphin.
Exactly,
does.
As
at some point
dolphin.
It was boom, like this. In fact, in the end of the maneuver was with a...
obviously a splashdown.
A splashdown. But after the splashdown, then it was there was the capsize.
Exactly. So the this kind of movement could not probably be avoided. Also, even if the flight controller was again on the controls, because the angle of attack of the foil was basically due to the inclination of the boat itself climbing. So. There is the possibility, not possibility, of trimming the trims on the other way, probably. So when the
absolutely, most probably, either it wasn't possible, or the trim tab was not working,
exactly.
working, or actually it was exactly he made a wrong
exactly.
a wrong decision.
Or a wrong
or a wrong pressing on the wrong button. So this is something.
Exactly. So when the boat splashed down, actually she splashed down already a lot heel to leeward.
Exactly. As we found out from the designs of the hulls, beautifully made by Tag Lang and Chevalier. The higher boat is likes to be heeled like 30 degrees
exactly.
and not to stay upright, doesn't like that much to stay upright, but likes to stay at 30 degrees. So the boat, we don't know if another boat like the English one, like Britannia or
like
the American one could have stayed anyway on his feet upright.
Exactly.
We don't know, but for sure the IA likes to heal a little bit
exactly.
Because of the shape of the hull, but then at some point reaches
exactly.
the point
the problem,
where
the problem is the windward arm is when the windward arm is in the upright position, actually when the boat heals more
exactly.
the righting moment of the windward arm is decreasing of increasing, so
exactly.
Actually you are always having obviously a positive writing moment, but this writing moment is decreasing, so actually the boat starts to heal and
exactly.
probably goes quite quickly over the non-returning point and
exactly.
actually goes with all the mass down.
Exactly. I mean, obviously the foil to leeward is not helping in this moment. No. On the opposite, it is helping to capsize because it has its weight, but without the speed, it is not providing lift.
Exactly.
So with a very, very low speed at that point, it isn't providing lift, so it is basically helping the boat to capsize, until the mast reaches the water. We remind you that the mast has a chamber inside, so it cannot in theory capsize completely 180 degrees.
Exactly.
Possible. So it stays at 90 degrees. But the good part is that it was quite a gentle.
Exactly. Exactly. This is something honestly I didn't think about before seeing this, but actually the leeward foil, when the leeward foil reaches the vertical position, let's say, it starts actually to have some writing moments. So if you think about a catamaran or another boat, mostly the catamaran, when it reaches the capsize angle, there is nothing actually in the writing moment which is increasing. So the boat starts accelerating in the hill and continues to accelerate towards the mast, touch the water. So the catamarans, for example, are quite always breaking the wing, no? When they are capsizing.
Exactly. In this case, it didn't happen, so they kept on sailing after this accident.
Exactly.
But then the boat was. Was brought again on his feet. On his feet, in this case, by towing with a tender boat with a rib. The rib was going backwards and pulling probably with a rope around the mast. Not around the mast, but I mean in this position mode,
exactly.
More or less. And so the boat went upright again on. Port tack,
exactly.
not with the wind just in front, as you normally do,
exactly.
When you are doing by yourself, no?
Exactly.
So there is no way actually to put the bow, against the wind, no?
Perfectly.
So this maneuver with towing works quite
exactly.
Quite well.
Even if the rules have actually some points to try to be the boat auto writing. Actually, the criteria is a static criteria, so I'm not too much seeing the boat really going on its feet on herself. So
yes.
Actually, this is a quite a gentle maneuver for sure. Stresses a lot less the boat. Avoid to have probably some people controlling the. The foils on board, which is
the arms, obviously during,
something
during,
you don't
exactly.
want, no?
Exactly.
Someone on board when you are doing this kind of maneuver.
Exactly. So I mean, it's difficult to think about about
self-writing.
Probably not. But anyway, this system works quite well. Let's say so. The first capsize we really see. Not a big effect on the rig, so a good assessment of what these boats can do, and another thing we can easily say, but we already said it.
Yeah.
If the boat is in its correct position,
yeah.
Then you have a lot of controls, and then everything works quite well.
Yeah.
But once you start. The disaster, then it's very difficult to prevent the disaster from happening. So you need to have the boat always on.
Exactly. It seems setup. Like the range of possible stable flight modes of this boat is for me wider than the ones of the catamarans, for example, mostly for maneuvering. But anyway, this assessment has a limit, no? So if you overtake the limit, if you pass the boundary, then you capsize or you splash down or something bad happens.
Esatto. Ciao, good day.
Ciao.